On December 29, 2023, the U.S. President Joe Biden took a final decision to terminate the designations of Uganda and other three sub-Saharan African countries as beneficiaries of the African Growth and Opportunity Act of a claimed failure by Uganda to meet eligibility criteria with observance of human rights quoted highly. Bahati has urged Ugandans to understand that the decision made by Parliament on homosexuality in Uganda was intended to defend the institution of family and no regrets to that. The decision has put the government of Uganda in a dilemma. The Minister of State for Trade in charge of industries, David Bahati, has come out to express disappointment with the U.S. decision, wondering how trade between the two countries is related to human rights.
So when you take T-shirts from Uganda to America, you don't ask whether this one is a homosexual or is not a homosexual. What you ask for is the size, the type, and the price. So for them to make a decision about this, the logic is really lacking. Nevertheless, we'll continue to pursue.
AGOA, a U.S. Trade Preference Act, was enacted in 2000 to provide duty-free access of over 6,000 products from beneficiary African countries to the U.S. market. Other affected countries are the Central African Republic, Gabon, and Niger. But the government says they have embarked on a search for alternative markets.
With a population of around 1.2 billion people, and it will be 2.5 billion people in 2050. This is a huge market for us. We have also signed with other markets like Chinese, preferential markets like China, European Union, the Asians. We are opening up in the Arabs.
Speaking to the press in Kampala, Bahati noted that the U.S.'s decision will turn out as a blessing in disguise for African countries, which have not been trading well among themselves. The minister asked other African nations to learn from Uganda's ordeal and use this as a lesson to build a base for the continent's economic survival in order to avoid reoccurrency of such scenarios.
A wake-up call for the African countries and African leaders to know that we need to build our own base for economic survival. For example, we are now opening markets with Algeria to sell our milk. What Africa needs to do, and which we are going to really focus on, is looking at infrastructure to facilitate inter-trade within the African continent.
Bahati says the government will not close doors for dialogue, but will continue exploiting all possible avenues to convince the U.S. to rescind its decision.
There's been some discussion at the highest level, at the level of the president, and I'm sure that these discussions will continue, but at the moment we have to prepare for what is pertaining, and what's pertaining at the moment is that they have taken a decision to disengage us from that market, and we are looking for alternative markets so that the things that we have been exporting there are exported to other markets. And the largest market that we have at the moment is the East African Community, is the African Continental Free Trade Area.
However, the Shadow Minister of Foreign Affairs, Muada Nkunyingyi, has implored the government not to give up on AGOA, saying Ugandan products will lose credibility on the international market if they're rejected in America.
No one should tell you that you don't lose when you lose a free and open market in a developed economy like the United States of America. And dealing with the US means dealing with the world. When they close out AGOA, we are likely to also have blockade of our products, even in other markets, because the American market was not only an incentive and a welcome gesture for our country, but as well it was a commendable recognition of our products and the produce. Once you trade in the American market, you easily trade in other markets.
Uganda has fetched $377.294 million from exports to the United States market in the last five financial years, with $87.7 million in the financial year 2022-2023 alone. Muada also faulted government for failure to meet eligibility criteria, saying that the Anti-Homosexuality Act that was passed recently is not the only factor that caused problems to Uganda, but also gross abuse of human rights against political opponents played a vital role.
We're aware that it had to commit to observe human rights. It had to commit to observe and take steps in protection of human rights, political pluralism, good governance, the rule of law, among others.
The Biden administration also imposed sanctions against Johnson Bevashaija, the Commissioner General of Prisons, on allegations of engaging in torture and other cruel, inhumane or degrading treatment or punishments against prisoners held within UPS facilities. Report compiled by Fred Kajubi for the news.